Hi, I'm Roger Dooley. Today I'm coming back to a topic that's getting a lot of attention, AI podcasts. If you're a podcaster or just curious about how AI is changing content creation, just stick around. I've got an amazing new tool to tell you about. Lately, I've been testing two impressive tools, Google's NotebookLM and a newer one called Jellypod. One of the things I love about podcasting is the personal connection it creates. When listeners hear a host's voice in their ears, it can feel like a one-on-one conversation. But now, tools like NotebookLM and Jellypod are doing something kind of revolutionary. They are removing the human podcaster from the equation and replacing them with AI. Is that good or bad? You tell me. Let's start with NotebookLM. You've probably heard about their audio overview feature. I've done a couple of videos, including a how-to tutorial. Please check them out if you haven't seen them. NotebookLM uses your content to create podcast-like conversations hosted by two remarkably lifelike AI voices. The results are impressive. They sound natural. They add little pauses, ums, and conversational quirks. They even ad-lib things like, oh yeah, that always happens to me. I hate that. It's a fantastic demonstration of AI's potential, but it does have a few limitations. NotebookLM gives you two hosts, but you can't change their voices, accents, language, or even have a solo host. The platform generates the episodes for you, and your control over the content is limited. It's polished, sure, but for someone looking to create a highly customized podcast, it's not quite there yet. That's where Jellypod comes in. This tool is designed to be a true podcast creation platform, giving creators much more control. You can customize your hosts, choose from a library of voices, or even clone your own. Want a solo host? No problem. Need a multi-host setup with different accents or genders? Jellypod can handle that. The customization extends to content, too. Jellypod lets you input text, URLs, or both, and then generates an episode outline broken into chapters. You can edit these chapters, add new ones, and refine key points. While you can't directly edit the transcript, the iterative process makes it fairly easy to get what you want. Another standout feature is multilingual support. Want to reach a global audience? Jellypod can produce podcasts in multiple languages. And once your audio is ready, Jellypod sets up your podcast feed so you can easily publish your episodes to platforms like Spotify. Now, I know what you're wondering. What does Jellypod sound like in action? To give you a sense of its capabilities, I created a short podcast clip featuring two AI hosts. One is a voice clone of me, and the other is Nigel Watson, a character I created using Jellypod's voice customization tools. So listen to this and see what you think. Because they connect on a more human level. So when you're thinking about building campaigns, maybe it's not just about the product. Maybe it's about the story you tell and the emotions behind it. So let's dive a bit deeper into this emotion versus reason debate. We know from that recent study, older adults had a 22% recall rate when exposed to emotional ads. Quite a jump compared to just a 7% recall for rational ads. Isn't that crazy?
Quite revealing, Roger. And it speaks volumes, doesn't it? It's almost like our brains are hardwired to latch on to emotion, far more than cold, hard facts. It's as if the emotional messages sneak past our logical defenses.
It makes you wonder why anyone's still relying on rational appeals, doesn't it? The data's clear.
Exactly.
Emotion really, really sticks. Okay, enough of that. What do you think? You know, I think at times the voices seem really human. The one voice clone sounds like me, but they have moments where they sound kind of robotic or just odd, where the intonation doesn't match the content of what they're saying. I'd say they haven't fully crossed the uncanny valley yet at Jellypod. Now, in its current form, NotebookLM is a phenomenal showcase for AI podcasting. Its lifelike hosts and conversational touches make it feel really natural. But Jellypod is the better option for creators who want a production tool, not just a demo. For example, if you're planning to turn your podcast audio into video with speaking avatars using a tool like HeyGen, Jellypod's solo host option makes that much easier. Plus, Jellypod gives you more control over your content and format. Of course, both tools are evolving fast. Google will likely add more customization options to NotebookLM, and Jellypod's voice technology will improve over time. For podcasters, this is an exciting and, to be honest, a little bit intimidating moment. These tools are making it easier than ever to create and share content. So what do you think? Have you tried either of these tools, Jellypod or NotebookLM, yet? How would you compare them? Let me know in the comments. I'd love to hear your thoughts. And be sure to hit like and subscribe. Bye for now.